Auburn has hired their new offensive coordinator, and he comes from the Seattle Seahawks. It is the quarterback's coach, Austin Davis. He played college football at Southern Miss. He was an undrafted quarterback in 2012, but he became a journeyman, played for the Rams in 2012, the Dolphins in 2013, the Rams again in 2013 and 14, to the Browns in 2015, Broncos in 2016, Seahawks in 17, Titans in 18, and then he became an assistant quarterback coach in 2019 with the Seahawks, and then was the quarterback's coach in 2020 and 2021 with the Seahawks. So he was the quarterback's coach for Russell Wilson. Now, Wilson already knows how to play the quarterback position, right? Like, we don't have to worry about that part. But he has been a part of a Pete Carroll and Brian Schottenheimer and Russell Wilson offense. He was a part of that. There were ups and downs, obviously. But we have no idea how this hire is going to turn out. No clue. You would hope that somebody that you would bring in would not only be able to develop somebody, but also be able to recruit. And Harsin, while he did have a big, big end of the recruiting cycle here, let me pull up the rankings here as we look. I've got the overall pulled up. Auburn ended up ranked number 13. They had 19 commits, and 10 of them were 4-stars. So it's pretty far down the pecking order. The people that are ranked ahead of them in the SEC, by the way, Missouri, Kentucky, Georgia, Alabama, A&M. So not that many that were ranked ahead of them, but right there with them is Tennessee. You got LSU back in 19. You know that they'll be back to normal pretty soon. Arkansas at 20, South Carolina at 21, Mississippi State 23, Ole Miss at 25. Like, there is a lot going on here. You would hope that one of your coordinators would be a big-time recruiter. I don't know that Derek Mason is, and I don't know that the new guy, Austin Davis, is. Now, Davis certainly can prove me wrong, but this is an incredibly interesting hire for Auburn, and we'll see how it works out. Like, this is certainly a move that shows that Harsin is doing it his way. I initially said that Mike Bobo was an Auburn booster push, that they wanted somebody in there that understood the SEC, that knows what's going on. Harsin got rid of him. In the middle of the year, he got rid of his wide receivers coach that he actually brought with him. There's just a lot of mayhem. 6-6 seasons on the plains do not go well, even if it is your first year and the starting quarterback gets injured, right? They do not deal well with that. So we'll see what happens. I would imagine Austin Davis is somebody that is going to, he'll still be pro style, but I would imagine it is somebody that is going to weigh heavily in the favor of the analytics when it comes to fourth downs, when to go for it, etc. Harsin, I think, is progressive when it comes to that. But again, this is interesting. Incredibly unproven guy. He is only, he's 32 years old. So he's a young guy. We'll see. We'll see. I mean, he's older than Dillingham, I believe, that I was just talking about. I will actually look that up as we speak. But yes, this is a strange one. I'm not going to say it's a bad hire, because obviously we have no idea. No idea as it sits. But it is certainly unproven. Yeah, Dillingham is 31. 31, and he has been coaching in college football since 2014. So, yeah, it's a little bit different. Little bit different situation there. So we'll see what Auburn ends up doing with that. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.